Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Mr. Parag.
Thank you very much for being here today and giving us your valuable time. So, you know, just to get straight to the point, water is on fire, as they say right now in India. There is a huge amount of water problems. We're reading about it every day. We're hearing about it. There are problems. I mean, recently what happened in Bihar, the encephalitis problem also can be attributed largely to water and contamination in water and so on and so forth. My question to you really is, coming from Punjab, which is blessed with the rivers and which has always been, you know, we've always heard all our lives, ki Punjab ka pani bada meetha hai. So how is Punjab dealing with this situation right now?
Prag, you're absolutely right that not only Punjab or any particular state like Bihar or UP, the whole India, there is a shortage of drinking water. Like when I say drinking water, there is a, when say we all say that there is water every day, but not a drop to drink.
Absolutely.
So the thing is this, that Punjab, no doubt, Punjab means panch aab, panch darya. So there was enough water.
Right.
Before the partition.
Ji.
And when the partition took place, and then Indus and Ravi, two main rivers, they went towards Pakistan side. Ji. We have a little, portion of Ravi
right.
with us.
Right.
But unfortunately, the global warming and then cropping pattern in Punjab, particularly,
Ji.
And in general whole of India, we are growing wheat and rice.
Ji.
When we are growing rice, so there is a lot of consumption of water by that particular.
So please correct me if I'm wrong. I understand that it takes 5,000 liters of water for every kilo of rice that is grown. Is that right?
You are absolutely right, because for 3 to 4 months.
Ji.
The water has to stand in the field,
Ji.
Keep on standing water when the paddy is growing and it comes to flowering and then it gets the seed on
right.
for rice. So keeping in view all those things, the water used by canals is and then by tube wells. You know, I give you an example in Punjab about 30, 35 years back. The water used to be at 10 feet.
Ji.
When we used to put a hand pump,
Ji, Ji.
So
Ji,
after that. 10 feet or 20 feet, we could put the hand pump, and 40 feet, we would get a tube well, which would give you 3-4 inches of water immediately.
That's right.
The same situation, if we now you dig inside for water, you will have to go down more than 230 feet, maybe 300 feet or 400 feet, but still, unfortunately, the water is not drinkable.
It's not drinkable.
Because there is a lot of fertilizers.
That's right.
Pesticides have been used, and the groundwater is decreasing day by day. The level has gone so down. So keeping in view, that is why you must be seeing there's a lot of states in India where they are having, river water sharing or canal water sharing problems. Like there is a problem between Haryana, Punjab and Rajasthan.
Right.
Then we
Even
have,
Delhi for that matter.
Then we have problems in South,
right.
The same river water sharing. So all these things, sharing of water with the state is only arising because day by day, the shortage of water is coming up a big issue and a major issue. Secondly, to come out with this, till now I would say that India has not taken it seriously.
Right.
Because we thought that we have enough rivers, enough canals, enough nadis, rivulets, but we never thought that suddenly we will, dams are there, certain dams, we need to build more dams to have a water reservoirs. And now we, in certain towns, we're also, like in Chandigarh, we are now making it a compulsory, the government, that rain harvesting, you know, so you collect water for your each house so that there is no shortage. So it is a it's a very major issue which is coming up, and with that, when the water is contaminated, there's a lot of iron and various other chemicals which are found in water, which is not good for health. The East Punjab and various other places, Rajasthan, UP, we are full of cancerous disease only because of drinking water.
Right.
There is a train which starts from Punjab. It goes to Bikaner because there is some charity hospital. And the name of the train is Cancer Train, because people go on that train who are cancer patients. So this is the situation of.
So water. I think we are all. I thank you for your I appreciate your knowledge and your understanding of the entire problem, because obviously there are not too many people, even on the political side, with all due respect, who really understand what the problem is. But having said that, I think, despite all these problems, on the other side, there is a massive shift now. And I think right to water or right to safe water is now becoming the order of the day. So we've seen that recently introduced as a bill in the Legislative Assembly of Madhya Pradesh, where the newly elect chief minister has brought in the right to water. And he wants to make it a constitutional right. And I think that is really a way forward. So right, and I think your government being the champion of delivering rights to people for the last so many years, whether it's right to information, right to education, and so on and so
right
forth.
Right to food, we gave.
Right to food.
Dr. Manmohan Singh,
yes,
he gave it.
Absolutely. The food security bill was introduced in the parliament.
I think I absolutely agree with you. Right to clean water, potable water is very, very important. Because if we do not, now we are more than 70 years old after the independence.
Absolutely.
And at this stage of life, the population has grown. You know, when India, Pakistan got separated, we were only 30 crore.
Right.
Now we are 1.3 billion.
Right, 130 crore.
We have 130 crore.
Correct.
So in 70 years, we have increased population is by 100 crore.
Correct.
So what I mean to say is that if we do not secure, we do not work on this, we do not save water, a drop by drop, I think will be a major problem. In Punjab, my chief minister of the view, Captain Amrinder Singh, we were very liberal a few years back to give connections to the farmers, to put in tubewell and electric connections. But we have restricted now. We are, we know that maybe he needs it, but we can't afford to give it.
Right. So I think there are two points I want to add over here at this point. And, being the founder of a social enterprise like Janajal, we have our own take on this. There are two ways forward, and please correct me please add further to what I'm saying. Is one is digitizing or infusing technology in the management of all water infrastructure. And when I say water infrastructure, I mean water treatment plants. So the PhD department of every state has installed thousands of plants which are currently not being optimized in terms of their capacity or their operations, simply because they were all set up on a manual basis over the last few decades. If these are digitized, that is a massive way to meet the gap between demand and supply. That is one. And thereby create a water sharing economy. I think it's very important that, maybe the state can think on the lines of creating a water sharing economy, because these are the two points or the two causes that we are really advocating as a social enterprise. What do you think about this?
Pragji, I again agree, your thought is very positive and correct, because if we do not work on saving water, you must understand in whole of India, whatever water we are consuming, the same amount of water we are wasting.
Oh, you're so right. You're so right, sir.
It is exactly the same. If we only stop wasting the water, like people use tap, the tap would keep on flowing, nobody shuts it.
In fact, just three weeks ago, the NGT, the National Green Tribunal, has made a recommendation to the Government of India that RO plants at the domestic level, at the household level, should be banned. Because every municipal corporation is dispensing water to people which does not need RO. RO is actually reverse osmosis, is actually a technology for groundwater. It is not meant to be applied to municipal water. So what is also happening is a lot of water is being destroyed at the city level, thereby depriving the rural parts of availability of basic water.
I agree with you. I like Jal Board in Delhi.
Ji.
And there are other, organizations like local bodies or municipal corporations. They must start working, and the present government must, at the central level and the state level, pass this legislature to conserve the water. And jahan tak you are saying about RO thing, that should not be at individual. We are bound to, when we say right to water, then we need to put RO at the very source of it, where the water is, we are storing.
So while it is there at the source, doesn't it need to be banned at the next level, which is at the household level?
Correct. So that's what I'm saying.
Ek hi pani ko double RO karna.
So we should, this is number one, this is a extra, burden on the poor and middle class and semi-middle class or upper class families who buy the ROs for 10,000 or 15,000. Then the maintenance is there. Then sometimes it works. The government has and must supply a clean water, a drinkable water to every person, in every town and every corporation. So this legislation, if it comes, I think people will in general will appreciate that, and I personally feel this is a need of the hour. And secondly, to conserve water, we need to come out with some innovative ideas. We should put our research teams, research and development teams, so that we can work up to the latest technology, how to clean the water which is going waste, or how to preserve the water which we are otherwise flowing in the dirty channels or various other things. And we should stop and start educating the people and the from the school level. There should be a chapter, I would say,
that's right,
in education system.
I think
that where we need to say that save water, and this is very important for life, because pani aur hawa
ji,
ये दोनों चीजें जो हैं इसमें आज पोल्यूशन है धरती पे पोल्यूशन है
जी
तो दिस इज टू बी टेकन केयर ऑफ एंड ये तो हमारे गुरुओं ने भी कहा है
जी जी
कि जो पानी और धरती माता का सम्मान दिया उन्होंने दैट्स लाइक मदर और पानी को उन्होंने पिता कहा है
बिल्कुल
और अच्छी हवा की बात करी है तो ये चीजें कोई उन्होंने तब सोच रखा था आज से सैकड़ों साल पहले की बात है
जी आई थिंक सर कहीं ना कहीं पानी हैज टू बी अ चार्ज्ड कमोडिटी एंड आई थिंक द प्राइसिंग ऑन वाटर हैज टू स्टार्ट गेटिंग लेवीड एट द गवर्नमेंट लेवल सिंपली बिकॉज अनलेस दैट इज डन इट विल नॉट बी सेव्ड और कंजर्व्ड टिल इट इज मेड अवेलेबल फॉर फ्री और एज क्लोज एज पॉसिबल टू फ्री इट विल ऑलवेज गेट वेस्टेड So, from our own experience, we have seen people who under CSR, we installed water filtration plants. People have taken water and we've seen them washing their buffaloes with it, washing their cows with it, because it came to them free.
I have already mentioned that the water we consume of the same quantity or maybe more than that, we waste it.
Ji.
Like we'll be washing our cars for 1 hour.
Ji.
We'll be doing unnecessarily washing the roads. Washing the other thing. There are so many other ways to clean it.
Correct. So I think that's where the awareness has to, the social awareness
has
to.
So we have in villages, we have water ponds, which is need to be cleaned. And in Punjab, we have started that work. So we are giving those clean ponds so that animals and other things, all other animals can have a better drinking water also.
Right.
So this is a need of the hour. I think it's a very good issue to come forward with various debates and research and development.
So we are there. I mean, you know, I think Punjab is a highly respected state in India. I think people look up to the leadership of Captain Amrinder Singh, people like yourselves who are there to really set a new benchmark, deliver a paradigm shift in the way water must be handled, managed, and delivered.
I'm sure with the present situation, Punjab is going to lead the country.
And being the sports minister, water, hydration, water is integral to...
So we are also like, you know, it was a thought that in every stadia we must have a water ATMs. In hospitals we should have water ATMs.
Absolutely.
In colleges, in universities, you know, all public places and bus stops. So that people at least get
Please implement that. I think that will be a giant step forward. People get, you know, the government of India is talking about smart cities.
Yes.
But we know at the level, at the ground level, for people to receive safe access to safe drinking water itself means that their city has turned smart. So the first step towards a smart city is access to safe drinking water.
I think I agree, 100% agree with you. I think in smart city, the first point should be the clean drinking water. Potable water.
Absolutely.
Is the necessity. And for that, I would also ask my respected Honourable Chief Minister to write a letter to the Honourable Prime Minister,
sir,
so that we can work on that and all states pass a legislation for right for drinking water.
Sir, whenever the other states do it, whenever the Prime Minister does it, but we definitely expect the government of Punjab to take the leadership on this, and at the state level, in whatever way possible, in whatever at whatever scale and level possible, is move this narrative into that to that level.
No,
where,
I agree with you, Pragji, but with this I will go a little ahead of that, because only not the governments, not only other legislation or other things will work, unless, you know, the people also start thinking. They should be guided, they should be educated. NGOs should come up. It's a big job, it's a big challenge for them.
It's a multi-pronged effort. There is no
like I said, if you start teaching, if we can teach a young 3-year-old child this is A for apple, B for ball, W for water, so we must teach him or her how to conserve, how to save water.
Correct.
So NGOs can really work to help out this problem of drinking water.
We are very confident that with the, you know, sometimes when the problems break out, the best solutions and the best intent surfaces. And I think we are at that juncture now where the problem has broken out, the problem is very severe. And I think people and the political side and the public side will collaborate, work. I think this is the best form of PPP that can really...
Yeah, I think this is, you are right. I agree with you on this.
Come into effect.
Thank you.
So we look forward to that, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It was wonderful to chat with you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Okay.